سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How are you all children? I hope you all are fine and doing the maths practice regularly. Today we are going to continue our same topic, fractions. Let's just recall what we have studied so far in fractions. In our previous two videos, we saw the different types of fractions. We have seen proper fractions, improper fractions, mixed fractions, like fractions and unlike fractions. And then in our next video, we saw what do we mean by equivalent fractions and how we find the equivalent fractions, right? Today we are going to compare the fractions, we are going to arrange the fractions in ascending and descending order, and further we are going to add and subtract the fractions. Now all these things what we are going to do today will be related to like fractions, okay. So what do we mean by like fractions? Just recall from what we have already learned. Like fractions are the fractions that have same denominators. The denominators will be same. They will have different numerators, but denominators remain the same. These type of fractions are called like fractions. So we are going to compare the like fractions today. We will arrange them in ascending and descending order. Also, we will add and subtract the like fractions, okay. So the first thing that we are going to do is comparison. Comparison means we are going to check which fraction is greater and which fraction is smaller. Now in like fractions, since we will have the same denominators, we have to just compare the numerators and find out which is greater and which is smaller. So the first example that I have here, 6 by 8 and 9 by 8. The denominators are same. So we just have to compare the numerators, 6 and 9. So 6 is smaller than 9. So 9 by 8 will be greater than 6 by 8. Okay, this is how we compare and put the sign. Next, 7 by 5 and 2 by 5. Now, since our denominators are same, 5 and 5, we will simply compare the numerators, 7 and 2. 7 is greater than 2, so 7 by 5 will be greater than 2 by 5. Okay, now next, 4 by 3 and 4 by 3, both are equal. So equal. This is how we do comparison of like fractions. We simply have to compare the numerators and put the sign. Okay. Same thing we are going to use to arrange the like fractions in ascending and descending order. Okay. First we are going to arrange the fractions in ascending order. Ascending order means small to big. You can see the fractions are all having the same denominator. So they are like fractions. So we have to only compare the numerators and start arranging them from small to big. So which will be the smallest fraction? I have 9 by 2, 1 by 2, 6 by 2, 4 by 2 and 5 by 2. The smallest number in the numerator is 1. So 1 by 2 is the smallest. Then next, 4 by 2, 4 by 2. You see the numerators we have to arrange from small to big. The entire fraction or the all the fractions will be arranged in ascending order. Then next we have 5 by 2. Next will be 6 by 2. And then the greatest fraction is 9 by 2. So this is how we arrange like fractions in ascending order. Now same thing we are going to do for descending order. Descending order means big to small. So first we start from the greatest fraction and slowly move on towards the smallest one. Since the denominators are same, we are going to compare the numerators. 7, 9, 2, 11 and 6. So which is the greatest numerator over here? 11. So 11 by 8 is the greatest fraction. Then 9 by 8. Then we have 7 by 8, then we have 6 by 8 and the smallest one will be 2 by 8. This is how we arrange the like fractions in ascending and descending order. Now next we are going to look into the addition of like fractions. Again addition of like fraction, it is very simple. Denominators are same, right? So in the answer also we will keep the same denominator. Simply we have to add the numerators. The first example, it is 1 by 5 plus 3 by 5. My denominator for the answer will remain the same. Okay, I will add only the numerators here. So 1 plus 3, 1 plus 3 is 4. So 4 by 5 is the answer. We keep the new denominator same and add the numerators. Okay, let's try to add the mixed fractions. Again, in the mixed fraction, the fractional part you can see it's like fraction, the denominators are same. Now here in mixed fraction we have a whole number and a proper fraction, right? Here also we have a whole number and a proper fraction. We will add the whole numbers separate and the fractional part separate. Okay, so whole number we have 4 plus 3. 4 plus 3 is 7. Okay, 4 plus 3, I have added the whole numbers. Then we are going to add the fractions. 2 by 3 plus 1 by 3. Both are having 3 as the denominator. So, denominator remains the same. Okay, and we are going to add only the numerator. That is 2 plus 1. Okay, see here, I can just show you all in the rough. First, what I did is 4 plus 3. These are the whole numbers that I have added. I got 7 as the answer when we add the whole numbers. Then the fraction part, 2 by 3 plus 1 by 3. Okay, now denominator remains the same, 3. I will add the numerators, 2 plus 1. 2 plus 1 is 3 by 3. Okay, so here I will write 3 by 3. This is how we add the like fractions. Okay, now same way we are going to see how we subtract the like fractions. I have 7 by 8 minus 2 by 8. Denominators will remain the same again. So we have to only subtract the numerators. So denominator will remain the same, 8. We will subtract the numerator, that is 7 minus 2. So 7 minus 2 is 5. 5 by 8 is the answer. Okay. Next, second example that I have, it's a mixed fraction. 5 3 by 4 minus 2 1 by 4. Again, I'm going to subtract the whole numbers first. 5 minus 2. 5 minus 2 is 3. Okay. So, I'll write 3 here, the whole number. Then, I'm going to subtract the fractions. 3 by 4 minus 1 by 4. Now denominator remains the same, 4. I will subtract the numerators, 3 minus 1, that is equal to 2 by 4. Okay, so 3, 2 by 4 is the answer. I hope you have understood all that we have discussed today. Quickly we will look into it again. We started with comparing of the like fractions. Since the denominators are same, we have to compare the numerators and check which number is greater. Okay, where the numerator will be greater, that fraction will be greater in value. So 6 by 8 and 9 by 8. We saw that 9 was greater than 6. So 9 by 8 is the greater fraction. Same thing we have used to arrange the fractions in ascending and descending order. Okay, depending upon the value of the numerator, we will arrange the fractions from small to big or big to small. Denominators are same since they are the like fractions. Then we have seen addition of like fractions. Again, the denominators will remain the same. We have to only add the numerators. And when we have a mixed fraction, we will add the whole number separate and the fractional part separate and write the answer. Same thing we will do, we have done in subtraction also. Denominators continues to be the same. We simply subtract the numerator. Okay. If it is a mixed fraction, first we subtract the whole numbers and then we subtract the fractions. I hope you have understood all that we have done today. Keep practicing children, and inshallah we'll meet very soon with our next topic. Till then, stay at home and be safe. Jazakumullahu khaira. Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi barakatuh.
Subhanallah, alhamdulillah.